भगवद गीता चैप्टर 1 वर्स नंबर 32-35। किम्नो राज्येन गोविंदा किम् भोगैर्जीवितेन वा येषामर्ते कांक्षितं नो राज्यं भोगा सुखानि च तैमेव स्थिता युद्धे प्राणां त्यक्त्वा धनानि च आचार्यः पितरः पुत्रस्तथैव च पितामहाः मातुला श्वशुरा पौत्राः श्याला सम्बन्धिनस्तथा एतान्नहन्तुमिच्छामि घ्नतोऽपि मधुसूदना अपि त्रैलोक्यराज्यस्य हेतो किं नु महि कृते निहत्य धार्तराष्ट्रान्न का प्रीति स्याद् जनार्दन। सो ट्रांसलेशन्स ऑफ चैप्टर 1 वर्स 32-35। ओ गोविंदा, ऑफ व्हाट अवेल टू अस आर अ किंगडम, हैप्पीनेस और इवन लाइफ इटसेल्फ व्हेन ऑल दोज फॉर हुम वी मे डिजायर देम आर नाउ अरेड ऑन दिस बैटलफील्ड। ओ मधुसूदना, when teachers, fathers, sons, grandfathers, maternal uncles, fathers-in-law, grandsons, brothers-in-law and other relatives are ready to give up their lives and properties and are standing before me, why should I wish to kill them, even though they might otherwise kill me? O maintainer of living entities, I am not prepared to fight with them, even in exchange for the three worlds, let alone this earth. What pleasure will we derive from killing the sons of Dhritarashtra? There are a few things here. See, Kimno Rajena Govinda. Why did he say Govinda? Because Govinda means one who is giving pleasure to the senses. So here, you know, Arjuna is telling, you are the one who give pleasure to the senses. Now please understand, you know, what I am thinking. Hope you will understand. For what reasons I don't want to fight, that's one thing. And another thing is, Prabhupada is writing that since you are the one giving pleasure to the senses, then I think you should give me some pleasure too. You know, give some pleasure to my senses. That's an indication. You know, Prabhupada is saying that, you know, Arjuna has addressed Lord Krishna as Govinda because, you know, okay, by using this significant word, Arjuna indicates that Krishna should understand what will satisfy Arjuna's senses. But Prabhupada writes, Govinda is not here to give pleasure to our senses. He will give to whatever extent we deserve, but not to the extent we covet. No. But if there is a devotee who is just keeping aside his, you know, sense gratification and only focusing on gratifying Krishna's senses, to such a devotee, Krishna will take a magnifying glass like that and he will see like what tiny desires are still there in his heart. Because there won't be any desire in a devotee's heart, in a sincere devotee's heart, in a pure devotee's heart. There won't be any desire other than one desire, that I should always try my best to please Krishna and his devotees. But Krishna still checks with a magnifying glass. Is there anything that, you know, my devotee has? Any small desire? Let me just, you know, grab the opportunity to fulfill the desire of my devotees. Like that, you know. So, Arjuna has here addressed directly, you know, please understand, you know, how you can satisfy my senses. So, that's not the right way of doing it. And then, Krishna is like looking at him, like, you fool. No, just looking, not saying anything. Like, you know, what are you saying? That you don't want to fight them. Then, do you think they will keep quiet? They will shoot arrows and they will kill you. How you can say, by coming here, that I don't want to fight? How you can say that? Like that, Krishna is just looking at him. And then Arjuna is saying, that is why Arjuna is replying. You know, even if they kill me, I will die, no problem. You know, I don't want to kill them. Because if I kill, I'll get sins. Instead, let them only kill. You know, it's better for me to live, you know, a frustrated life in the forest by begging. You know, it's not the business of a kshatriya to beg. Kshatriya is one, you know, who never takes donation, he only gives donation. Brahmanas take donation, they give donation. Vaishyas also take donation, they give donation, you know. But Kshatriyas, they never take donation. So now how Arjuna will go and stay in forest and begging for his food? You know, this is not, you know, actually what happened to him is he's bewildered. When he's bewildered, he cannot think sanely and he can only do nonsense, and that will lead to more frustration. That is because he has forgotten what Krishna wants. He's forgotten what is the duty of a Kshatriya as per Shastras. So then, you know, he says, that's why Arjuna says, even if they kill, I will die, you know. See, he's saying, see, why should I kill them? Even though they might otherwise kill me, because Krishna is looking at them, hey, they will kill you. Okay, even if they kill, that's okay, but why should I kill? But then Krishna is going like, what? You don't mind dying? You don't even want to kill Duryodhana and his brothers Dushyasana, who tried to disrobe your wife? Like that, you know, you don't want to kill at least Duryodhana and his brothers. So he's saying, no, what will I get by killing Duryodhana and his brothers when they all die? How am I going to share what I have and experience joy? You know, this is middle concept of life, which Arjuna was thinking and conveying. That's why he's saying, you know, what peace? See, he's saying, you know, what pleasure will we derive by killing sons of Dhritarashtra? There is no need for him to say that again here, but it's because, you know, Acharyas are commenting like that. Acharyas are commenting that, you know, like Krishna is asking, what about, you know, Kauravas? Maybe you can at least kill them, like that, you know. So he's telling, no, but I'm not going to get any peace if I kill them. Because, you know, even if these young boys, you know, when they have a nice girlfriend, they're not very happy until they keep her in the bike behind and they go around with high speed. And everyone should look at their bike and at their girlfriend. Then they are happy. Women, when they buy nice jewelry, you know, they can't wear it daily. So they wait to go to functions and they wait to wear the jewelry so that, you know, so that people will see in the wedding. And, you know, they are very satisfied only when people come and ask them, oh, nice one. It's a new one, huh? It's very nice. From where did you get? Like that, you know. Means when people admire, material people, you know, feel very happy. Like if someone admires the wealth of ours, if we are materialistic, then we become happy. But spiritual happiness is not like that. Now, we talk about Bhagavad Gita, you listen about Bhagavad Gita. Talking itself, you know, is the intention is to serve the devotees who need, you know, to understand Bhagavad Gita or who want to help others understand Bhagavad Gita. These videos are for, especially for teachers who want to teach, and also for students who are very new to get an idea of, you know, various perspectives of various acharyas. So when we are doing this with the intention of serving the devotees, we just become happy when devotees watch the videos, and especially when they put a like, we understand, oh, okay, you know, they are happy. Okay, somebody is liking it. Maybe it is good. Maybe we should continue. Actually, we had stopped in between. But yesterday, you know, some devotees from US told us that they are waiting for the video. It will be helpful. Then we thought somehow we have to do it. So we are sitting up at night and we are doing it. Because it is our service. If someone is going to benefit, we like to do it. So this is spiritual, you know. When anything spiritual is done, like we chant our rounds, we offer to Krishna. We don't need to go around telling people that I am chanting to become happy. We don't need to go around telling people I offer food to Krishna and then I eat. No, that we don't need. Sometimes we even hide that fact because people sometimes may not understand, you know, in the right perspective. But material wealth is opposite to spiritual wealth. Spiritual wealth is, you know, enjoyed even without showing off. You know, without showing off. When we try to show off spiritual wealth, then that is material. You know, it is tinged with material attitude. It's like that. So here Arjuna was talking like a materialist. He was telling how I can enjoy, and he was expecting finally by calling Krishna as Janardana. Janardana, you know, is the one who is going to actually give, you know, who is the maintainer of all living entities. So he's saying, even if you think that they deserve to die, even if you think that they deserve to die, then, you know, why should I kill them? You know, you are Janardana, you are the maintainer of living entities. So, you know, why don't you kill them? Then you will not get any sins because you are God. Like that. He's not saying that. He's just calling him Janardana, means maintainer of living entities. I mean, what are you doing? Why should I kill and go to hell? You know, because and as they surrender unto me, Bhurjan Prabhu writes that only after this war, only 37 years, the Pandavas ruled the kingdom. So Arjuna is having that kind of attitude in mind that, you know, maybe we will rule for few decades. And after that, when I die, because of killing all these Bhishma, Drona and others, I will go to hell and spend millions of years in hell there. Why should I spend millions of years of suffering in hell just in exchange for 37 years of ruling on this earth? No, that was his idea. He didn't want that, you know. That's why he's saying, better you are Janardana, you are the maintainer. Anyway, you know, it's your duty to kill also. So why don't you do that? That's an indication, you know. But actually, Krishna in future chapters, he says, I have actually killed them all. And even in Vishwarupa, he shows that how he's opening his mouth and how all the Kauravas are dying and going. No Pandavas were dying and going inside the mouth of Vishwarupa, but Kauravas were dying and going inside the mouth, which means he was declaring, because he said, what's going to happen? You know, Arjuna was wanting to know what's going to happen. So Krishna and Vishwarupa showed what's going to happen, you know, and then he says, Nimitta Matram Bhava Savyasachi, means you are just the instrument, I've already killed. Now you become instrument and take the credit. I don't need the credit. I have done, because if somebody offends me, I can forgive them. I forgive them. But if somebody offends my devotees, I can't take it. Therefore, even if you, Arjuna, want to excuse them, I cannot excuse. So I have already killed them. And you, I'm just convincing you to become an instrument only. Like that, you know. So that you'll get to hear in the future. Because here Arjuna is expecting Krishna to kill. So we are explaining that in future, Krishna is going to reveal that he has actually killed. He has actually killed and he just wanted Arjuna to be an instrument. Yes, we will see the next verse in the next video. Hare Krishna.